Hello everyone, it's David, and I'm here to introduce another video. So I hope everyone's doing well. Right, where do I start? When I started this channel, one of the goals I had was to show off everything that Osaka has to offer. I think Osaka gets slept on a little bit because you know, Tokyo is a much bigger city, it's much more famous. Kyoto is kind of more famous for the culture. But Osaka, what have we got apart from takoyaki? Okay. If you read a tourist guide, there are not many tourist guides for Osaka. So I want to kind of make my own. Okay. So to start that, I want to tell you a story. I saw this YouTube video, I'm not going to say who it is, but they made a top 50 places to go, or top 50 things to do in Osaka. So I thought, oh wow, that's a lot. Usually you see top 10 or top 15. So I thought, okay, I'll take a look. And actually more than 20 of those were not Osaka at all. They were Kyoto and Kobe. So I got kind of annoyed because, you know, I came for 50 Osaka places. And I thought, could we do it? Lots of people told me that 50 is a big number for Osaka. And okay, I agree. But anything's possible. So to that end, I'm going to start a new series of videos. I'm going to focus on different zones in Osaka Prefecture and talk about some interesting places there that you might not see in the tourist guide. Okay. Okay. Well, my final goal is to make a kind of top 50 places in Osaka or best 50. But Rome wasn't built in a day. I can't do that all in one go without a lot of traveling and editing, so I'm gonna do it piece by piece. Today I'm gonna start the first one, which will be about the kind of south central Osaka. So this will include Tennoji and sort of areas around there. So I'm gonna stop waffling and let you enjoy the video. Okay, thank you, see you soon, bye! Okay, our first stop is Ten-Shiba in the middle of Tennoji Park, which is a reconstructed area, very close to Tennoji Station. It also has the Tennoji Zoo in the back of it, which sometimes has special exhibits like the night zoo in the summer. So it's worth checking that out. It's very cheap too. So Ten-Shiba, Tennoji Park is, well, it's a big park. It's really good for summer days. Sometimes they have events. They're like a kind of slightly Japanese version of Oktoberfest, which I recommend going to see if you can. There are lots of new restaurants here too. They're a little more expensive than some places, including this place called Robert's, which is a bit of a weird name for a restaurant. But it's, yeah, quite a nice fancy place to go if some of Tennoji looks a bit rough. Okay, we've also got another new area called, I don't know how to say that, Ina, which also has a few more restaurants and some shops in there too, so you can have a wander around on a nice warm day. And dinosaurs for some reason. I think this is just a temporary exhibit, but the TikTokers are always there, I think. Okay, this is Osaka, if you didn't forget. So that will take us on to number two, which is Abeno Harukas. Now, this is the tallest building in Japan. Look, it's very big. And it was opened in 2014. And it is still, I think, the tallest building in Japan. And of course, with tall buildings, you can go to the top. So you can take this elevator ride. This part's for free as well, so you can just go up there and see the observation deck. There's also an art gallery in there too, which sometimes has exhibitions. Some Liechtenstein art museum this time. And this is a free sky terrace, so you can go up there and sort of enjoy the view without having to pay anything at all. So this part is totally free. And see lots of couples and I don't know what's going on here. Yeah. There's a nice view from the top. Like I said, you can go higher, but you have to pay about 1500 yen to go to the top deck. So the next place is Tsuruhashi, which is famous for being the kind of Korean town, lots of Korean immigrants there, and kind of old style Osaka. So for example, you can eat a lot of street food, things on sticks, you can see all of those, lovely. Give that a try. And most famous is yakiniku, which is a Korean style barbecue. So it's a very famous place to go there. You can see there's lots of narrow roads, a little bit crowded, but there's lots of places you can try out. So yakiniku is really nice. can be a little bit expensive, but the meat in Japan is really good, so I really recommend giving a try. Of course, you can just have a wander around. It's kind of old-fashioned in Tsuruhashi, so just find something you like. I think maybe it's not the safest area in the world, but well, compared to Japan anyway. But I mean, Japan's a very safe place anyway, so I wouldn't really worry about this this place. So feel free to have a wander, enjoy the local sights and smells, and go into a restaurant that looks interesting. They might not have an English menu though. Now, like I said, there's a lot of Korean immigrants in Tsuruhashi, so of course a lot of Korean food shops. You can see all that kimchi there. And if you go around some of the like shopping streets, you can see lots of Korean restaurants. You can buy all sorts there for takeout, or you can go inside and eat in their restaurants too. It's a very local, very like real experience if that's what you're after. Okay. So the next place is Shitennoji Temple, in just near Tennoji Station. It's one of the oldest temples in Japan, I believe. I think it was built in about the year 600 or so. Of course, like most temples, it's been burned down several times, but it's been reconstructed in the old style, so it's still good. You can see that big five-story pagoda as well. Now, that main area in the back, that's you do have to pay to go in there, but it's only like 300 yen, so go for it. Actually, it was free the day that I went, if you get lucky. You can also see the turtle pond, turtle power. They are real turtles. I mean, of course, turtles don't move that much, so you can enjoy those. There's so many, though. Yeah, you can see them swimming around, too. But they're surrounding this, this is the main shrine, so you can go there and pay your respects if you want to. Or you can just go and see the turtles, but don't feed them, and they're gonna mutate. And you can go inside this is the main temple area. Usually you can't go in this door, but it was a free open day, so I could do it. I definitely recommend going in there. They've just reconstructed it and done some repairs, so it's a nice place to visit, and it's only 300 yen. Sometimes you can go inside that big pagoda as well. It's kind of some national treasures inside there. But at the moment it's closed because of coronavirus. And there you go. If you just want to fill up your Instagram feed, you can just take a look there. Look at the nice red pillars, golden lanterns, and just enjoy yourself. It's a very peaceful day. And maybe you can meet some gods as well. We've got they come in lots of different flavours. We've got a red one there. I'm not showing my cultural knowledge here. And a blue one too. So please go and see these guys too. We've got to catch them all. Okay, and our last stop is Shinsekai, which is definitely one of the more old-fashioned areas of Osaka. A bit of a sketchy area, but I mean, there's a lot of tourists there during the day, so Japan's pretty safe, don't worry. You can see all these colourful restaurants. That's for puffer fish. So if you want to gamble and try the poison puffer fish, you can try it there. It's kind of an old-fashioned area, like I said, so it has a lot of vintage stuff there, a lot of amusement arcades. It was actually designed after New York's Coney Island and a bit of Paris, apparently, too. So also, it's famous for kushikatsu, which is the famous Osaka deep-fried things on sticks, so definitely give that a try. Of course, it's Osaka, so you can try takoyaki as well, octopus dumplings, and you can even go there with a giant octopus on the roof if you like. There's lots of little hidden restaurants too. You can go in these under these little awnings. There's also a restaurant where you can catch your own fish and then they'll fry it for you, but if you're not good at that, you can just order off the menu. That's fine. And the most famous place in Shinsekai is Tsutenkaku. It's been reconstructed before, but it's a big observation tower. You can go in there for about 900 yen. And yeah, this is a Shinsekai kind of, what can I say, arcade. So you can see some old amusements like gacha machines, little capsule toys, and some old arcades as well. So if you're into that, please take a look. This is really the vintage stuff, so if you want to see more modern stuff, then there's other places to go.
Hey, I hope you enjoyed that video.
I enjoyed travelling around to make it, so I hope you enjoyed it. That's the first one of a series. I don't know how many is in the series or when the next one is going to come, but I'm going to focus on another zone soon, another zone of Osaka, and we'll see some more places to visit. But until then, if you have any requests for videos you want to see, could be food videos, could be walking videos, could be tourist videos, anything is okay. Please leave a comment in this video or any video. Please like and subscribe, please. That's really going to help me because I'm a little channel. Comment and what's the other thing? The bell. Hit the bell. If you hit the bell icon, you'll get a notification next time I make a video. So please do that. It's going to help me a lot. Please. And hopefully I can get enough money to get some proper lighting instead of this crazy stuff here. Okay, so have a good weekend, whenever it is, and see you soon. Bye-bye.